Hello, Outport East here, Outport Doors, everything fishing, everything outdoors. And today, we're gonna take a look at this this Ruck 23 from the Hidden Woodsman. I've been getting, every time I post it on Facebook, every time I post it on Instagram, every time I post anywhere, I get so many questions about it. I posted a reel, or a short, it's called a short, on YouTube, and everybody's like, are you gonna review it? I posted it in the Hidden Woodsman group, and they're like, we'd love to see a review. I just had to use it. I had to just get used to the idiosyncrasies that I like and I don't like about the pack. I'm gonna tell you right now, I love the pack. I love a lot about it. There's some things that I'm going to say that, you know, I don't love about it, but that kind of pertains to what it's marketed to and not because of the pack. It's my opinion that I think the pack is wrongly marketed. It's marketed to maybe the wrong people, but I'll get into that. So I just want to show you the pack real quick. I'm Sam, welcome to the channel. Let's get right into the pack. So it's Hidden Woodsman. If you get the brown one, I'm not sure if he's gonna do it for all of them. You are going to get a 1000D Cordura, which is why I usually go for the brown. My Deep Woods Ruck 35 is a 1000D. My Tropical Ruck is a lightweight ruck is 500D, and I really love this 1000D Cordura. My day ruck is a 1000D. I'm really loving this stuff. So anytime I get the chance to get some 1000D Cordura, I always get it. Please pardon the wind. I can't do anything about it. But I'm gonna get out here and make a cup of coffee and just hang out for 30 or 20 minutes before I have to get back to work here. But anyway, we have a front pocket here, very similar to one of your fire pouches. Love the fire pouch. My truck is right here, actually. I should go get one and show you. I have another one. So there's your fire pouches there. And what I really loved about the front pouch is that it's a tad bigger than a fire pouch. And I really love that. Ton of space in there, lined with yellow. Some of them might be lined with orange, I'm not sure. But Malcolm always does that, and I love that. The attention to detail, he always puts a bright color in there, which I think is phenomenal. You go in here, you do have a hook and loop spot here, which I love that. I always put a patch on that. I have a prepared wanderer's patch that I really love that I put on all my packs. I love that patch, sorry. There's another small zipper here. Zippered pouch that you can put some stuff in. That is gonna begin to encroach on your capacity on the inside. So just keep that in mind. Sometimes I don't like these pockets too much because of that reason. Sometimes when you have a pocket like this that encroaches on the capacity of the inside, I kind of don't like those. I like it when the pouch is like external, like this one, so I could stuff that, and then it doesn't hinder the amount of space I have on the inside of the pack. Just something to think about. It's not a dock on the pack at all. I like external pouches better. Great, always great stitching, everything. That's why, I mean, you pay for the premium. I paid, I think it was about $207 with taxes and shipping. But that's what you pay for, guys. You pay for heirloom quality stuff. So you see we have a roll top, which can add a good amount of capacity. I'm gonna roll in a photo right here of it sitting next to the day ruck. It's a very similar size to the day ruck. When I spoke to Malcolm, he said this is about 21 liters to 23 liters. Everything that I fit in my day ruck fits in here. So that's how I measure. And the day ruck is 25 liters. So without my canteen pouches, I fit everything that goes in the center of my day ruck in here just fine. And if I like stuff it to the top, I could fit way more. When I first got it, I made a short where I showed me putting a bunch of stuff in here all the way to the top, and it actually looks really cool. It looks like a hiking backpack. This is a big boy. You know, I just put things in here to show what you can fit in. This is I believe that's a 15. It's between 14 and 15 inches, this hatchet. It's an Almike, Holzberg Almike, if you guys want to look that up. But if you could see, fits perfect in there. Perfect for a hatchet. I'm guessing you could fit a smart water bottle in there. But again, it's going to encroach on the inside capacity. So that's something I don't like too much about the pack, but it's okay. It matters what you're using the pack for. Roll top. Amazing, guys. I love roll top packs. I fell in love with it ever since I got my large Savota. The Pathfinder Scout pack has a roll top, which I think I should. I didn't do the large Savota review yet, but I should have it up here soon. I just camped out with it 3 nights ago, and I'm going on another camp this weekend with the Savota large. So I'm going to be doing a review of that as well. The Pathfinder Scout review is on my channel. So I love roll top. The reason why I love roll top is because it really makes your pack, it makes it hard for moisture to get in your pack, especially if you have 1000D Kidora. You know, this thing is virtually waterproof, you know, up to submersion. You know, you can get dumped on with this thing. And they sell sprays you could spray on your pack too, which I've never really gotten into. But I've gotten rained on with these packs, and I've used my tropical ruck in my canoe with water everywhere, and there's not water in it. So I think that's great. This pack is marketed as a EDC pack, like everyday carry. This is going to be my opinion on this, okay? I don't think this is the best EDC everyday carry pack. I used it for 2 weeks. 2 weeks. Everyday carry. I put my laptop in there. You know, stuff I carry every day. I'll roll in some stuff like I carried in those 2 weeks, and it carried it fine. I carry memory cards, laptops, you know, some, a Bible, some, I'm a pastor. So, and I do photography work and camera work. My 16 inch MacBook doesn't fit in this back pocket. I do have a 13 inch MacBook. That one does fit. But it has to be the new one. If it's one of the older ones, it probably won't. I just don't think it's a great EDC pack, to be honest. And that's my opinion. If you're an instructor at the Pathfinder school, I think this is a great EDC pack. EDC pack. If you live in Alaska and you're always out, and yeah, I think this is a great EDC pack. But for me, being a pastor at a church, I don't think it's a great EDC pack. And I don't want to unroll my pack every time I got to get something out of it, my notepad or anything. So that's just my opinion. But I do think it's a great little bush pack, a great day hike pack, a great overnighter pack, overnighter, no problem in this thing. So, there's my opinion on what it's marketed as. So in here, I got a couple things, got some water, got a canteen kit. I got a knife I want to check out. Just got this one, and I'm just gonna use it today and check it out. It's a Bear Forest Simple. I really love the look of it. Another pouch, and this is the big boy with all my stove, everything. Everything's in there. My lunch, everything. So if you look in there, capacity, I don't know, it's huge. I mean, to me it is. I can carry a lot of stuff in there. And it's really nice. The bedroll straps are built in. I would have rather liked to see two places to put a strap through. It just gives you more options. But this works fine, and it fits my small blanket, my small cotton blanket pretty well. Another thing I was trying to do is I tried to put my tripod down there, but you know, it was just a little hard because you got to tighten it with these. So for me, and guys, this is my opinion. This is the internet. You can get one and form your opinion. It might be the best EDC pack for you ever. But for me, what I do, you know, my tripod didn't really fit in here too well. It went a little too high, and then my tripod doesn't fit in here. So I won't be using this for an EDC pack. But for a bush pack, like your day ruck or whatever, this is great. I think it's awesome. And I definitely recommend you grab one and try it out. And I just wanted to show you guys a little bit of what fits in there and what you can use it for. So, quick video. Didn't want to do anything too crazy. As always, thank you for stopping by the channel. I really appreciate it. Just want to say God bless you guys. If you guys might be going through something today, just know that you're not alone. That if you think no one cares about you, man, I care about you. So that's one person. You can hit me up and I'll chop it up with you. I've been through a lot, and I like to say this on all my videos. If you're in a valley, your valley can change. God is a God of seasons. And you might be in a valley right now and think that you can never get out. You might be struggling with so many things, addiction, even thoughts of suicide, man. Dude, I've been there. And I just want to tell you that there's light at the end of the tunnel, even if you can't see the light. So guys, stay in there. If you're a veteran, I care about you. Thank you for your service. And just God bless you. I pray that there's joy that comes over you right now that doesn't make any sense. That there's peace that comes over you right now at the sound of my voice that doesn't make any sense. And it's all because of Jesus. Joy and peace over you in the name of Jesus. I really pray that over you. And I pray you guys have a blessed day, and I pray you guys enjoyed the video.